एलाइजा एंजाइम लिंक्ड इम्यूनोसॉर्बेंट एसे, एंजाइम लिंक्ड इम्यूनोसॉर्बेंट एसे। इट इज ए हाईली सेंसिटिव एक्सट्रीमली रिलायबल एंड सोफिस्टिकेटेड टेक्निक ऑफ एनालिटिकल बायोकेमिस्ट्री। वी विल डिस्कस दिस टेक्निक बाय जनरल इंट्रोडक्शन, बेसिक प्रिंसिपल, जनरल प्रोसीजर, टाइप्स एंड यूजेज ऑफ दिस टेक्निक। जनरल इंट्रोडक्शन। व्हेन एन एनिमल इज इंजेक्टेड विथ ए एंटीजन और एक्सपोज टू इन्फेक्शन, इट स्टिमुलेट द इम्यूनोलॉजिकल सिस्टम टू प्रोड्यूस एंटीबॉडीज। दीज एंटीजन्स एंड एंटीबॉडीज कैनॉट बी डिटेक्टेड बाय सिंपल एनालिटिकल मेथड बिकॉज दे आर प्रेजेंट इन ए वेरी लो कंसेंट्रेशन, इवन लेस देन 1 नैनोग्राम पर मिलीलीटर। दिस प्रॉब्लम हैज बीन ओवरकम बाय द यूज ऑफ एलाइजा। दिस टेक्निक कैन डिटेक्ट दीज एंटीजन एंड एंटीबॉडी प्रेजेंट इवन इन लेस देन 1 नैनोग्राम पर मिलीलीटर कंसेंट्रेशन। एलाइजा इज ए टेक्निक यूज फॉर द डिटेक्शन, क्वांटिटेटिव एस्टिमेशन एंड इम्यूनोलॉजिकल एसे ऑफ एंटीजन एंड एंटीबॉडी प्रेजेंट इन द बायोलॉजिकल सैंपल। दिस टेक्निक इज बेस्ड ऑन सम बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स। दीज आर फर्स्ट, एंटीजन एंड एंटीबॉडी रिएक्ट इन ए हाईली स्पेसिफिक मैनर टू फॉर्म एंटीजन एंटीबॉडी कॉम्प्लेक्स और एजी एबी कॉम्प्लेक्स। सपोज दिस वन है एंटीजन, इट रिएक्ट विथ दिस एंटीबॉडी टू फॉर्म एजीएबी कॉम्प्लेक्स। सेकेंड, एन एंटीबॉडी कैन बी लिंक्ड विथ ए स्पेसिफिक एंजाइम। दिस वन इज द एंटीबॉडी, दिस वन इज द एंजाइम, इन सच ए मैनर दैट नाइदर द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द एंटीबॉडी नोर द एक्टिविटी ऑफ द एंजाइम आर इम्पेयर। दे फॉर्म एंजाइमेटिकली एक्टिव इम्यूनोलॉजिकल कॉन्जुगेट। दिस वन इज द कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ एंटीबॉडी एंड द एंजाइम। थर्ड, दिस लेबल्ड एंटीबॉडी कैन बी लिंक्ड विथ ए स्पेसिफिक एंटीजन और एजीएबी कॉम्प्लेक्स। इन ए मीडियम फोर्थ, व्हेन द सबस्टेट ऑफ द एंजाइम विथ एप्रोप्रिएट रिएजेंट इज एडेड इन द मीडियम, द रिएजेंट ऑक्सीडाइज टू प्रोड्यूस ए स्पेसिफिक कलर इन द मीडियम। द अपीयरेंस ऑफ द कलर एंड द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ द कलर डिनोट द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ए पर्टिकुलर एंटीजन एंड एंटीबॉडी इन द बायोलॉजिकल सैंपल। जनरल प्रोसीजर। इन एलाइजा वी यूज ए स्पेशल माइक्रोटाइटर प्लेट नॉन एज एलाइजा प्लेट generally containing 96 val or depression at uniform interval. It is composed of polystyrene or polyvinyl. This one represent one of the veil of ELISA plate. In the first step, antigen present in the buffer solution to be tested are immobilized on the surface of the veil. Then we wash the veil to remove unbound or free antigen. For the washing, generally we use PBS, phosphate buffered saline of 0.05% 20. After washing, we add blocking buffer of non-reactive protein such as bovine, serum, albumin or milk protein Kg to cover those area which remain uncoated by the antigen. After that, we again wash the veil with the PBS. Then we add a labeled antibody containing the enzyme in the medium. Such antibody react with the antigen present on the surface of the veil. Then we wash the veil again with the PBS to remove any unbound or unreacted labeled antibody. Then we add the substrate of the enzyme along with appropriate reagent. During the chemical reaction, in presence of the enzyme and the substrate, the reagent oxidized to produce a specific color in the medium. Appearance of the color denote the positive test. As in this procedure, the antibody directly react with the antigen and only the primary antibody is used. No secondary antibody is used in the process. So this one is the process of direct ELISA. In the technique of ELISA, the enzyme for labeling of the antibody generally used are horseradish, peroxidase, alkaline phosphatase, galactosidase, leptoperoxidase. Horseradish peroxidase or HRP is generally or commonly used in the ELISA test. Hydrogen peroxide H2O2 is the substrate of this enzyme peroxidase. It converts it into H2O and O2. As in the presence of the electron donor reagent in the medium such as diamino, benzidine or 4-chloro naphthol, they are oxidized themselves. Due to oxidation of these reagents, they produce a specific color in the medium. Diamino benzidine produce dark brown color, whereas 4-chloro-naphthol produce the purple color. On the basis of the appearance of the color, the presence of antigen or antibody in the serum is detected. The intensity of the color produced by these reagents denote the quantity of the antigen or antibody present in the medium or in the biological sample. Types of ELISA. There are several modifications have been made in the basic ELISA to enhance sensitivity, flexibility and specificity of the technique. We will discuss three types of the ELISA: indirect, sandwich and competitive ELISA. In these three types of the ELISA, besides the primary antibody is used in the direct ELISA, secondary antibody are also used. These diagram represent the micro titer well of ELISA plate. The step of immobilization of antigen or antibody on the surface of the well, process of the addition of blocking buffer, which block the uncoated area of the well, and the process of washing by PBS, phosphate buffered saline, at various steps of the ELISA are similar with the general procedure. In indirect ELISA, the antigen of the interest are first immobilized on the surface of the microtiter well. Then we add the serum of the patient. If the serum contain the antibody, these antibody react with the antigen to form AgAb complex, antigen antibody complex. It is known as primary reaction. Then in the medium we add anti-Ig immunoglobulin, antibody against antibody labeled with the enzyme. These labeled antibodies react with the AgAb complex. When the substrate and the reagent are added in the medium in presence of enzyme, the reagent produce specific color in the medium. The appearance of the color denote the positive result, means the serum contains the antibody. When the antibody are absent in the serum, the labeled antibody cannot bind with the antigen. In such a case, it washed out during the washing. So, in absence of the enzyme, the color is not appear. Means, it give rise the negative result, means the serum is devoid of antibody. As in case of indirect ELISA, more than one antibody can be bind with the AgAb complex. So this technique is highly sensitive, flexible than the direct ELISA. In case of sandwich ELISA, specific antibody are immobilized on the surface of the vein, then the serum is added in the vein. If the serum contain the antigen, these antibody, which are known as TRAP antibody, form the AGFB complex, antigen antibody complex. Then we add the labeled antibody, which is also known as target antibody. In presence of the enzyme of the labeled antibody, the substrate and the reagent undergoes the chemical reaction. As a result, the reagent produces a specific color. The appearance of the color denote the positive result, means the serum of the patient contains the antigen. If the antigen is absent in the serum, this labeled antibody cannot bind with the primary antibody or TRAP antibody. In such case, in absence of the enzyme, the reagent doesn't produce any color. So, no appearance of the color denote the negative result, means the serum has no any type of the antigen. As in case of the sandwich, the antigen is trapped between the two antibody, or sandwiched between the two antibody, so called sandwich ELISA. As the specificity of the antigen is determined by two different antibodies, because such antigen contain at least two sites to bind the antibody, so sandwich ELISA is more specific than the indirect ELISA. In competitive ELISA, the antigen of low molecular weight are used. In this technique, the sample may be the crude or impure. This competitive ELISA is explained by taking the example of HIV antibody. The HIV antigen are immobilized on the surface of the vein. Then we add the serum of the patient. If the serum contains the antibody of the HIV, then they form the AGFB complex. Then we add the labeled antibody, means the antibody containing the enzyme, in the medium. If the serum of the patient contains the antibody of the HIV, then all the antigens immobilized on the surface of the vein are bounded by these antibodies. There is no free antigen to bind with the labeled antibody. In such case, these labeled antibodies are washed out during the washing. So, when the substrate and the reagent are added in the medium, as there is no enzyme in the medium, so the color is not appear. No appearance of the color denote the positive result, means the HIV antibody is present in the serum. These three types of the antibodies differ in some important difference. In case of indirect and the competitive ELISA, the whale contain the antigen, and in case of sandwich, the whale contains the antibody. In case of the indirect and the competitive, the serum of the patient may contain the antibody, whereas in case of sandwich, the serum of the patient may have the antigen. In indirect and the sandwich, the appearance of the color denote the positive result, whereas no appearance of the color in the competitive ELISA denote the positive result. In case in the competitive ELISA, if the color is appeared, means the labeled antibody is bind to the antigen, it means the serum is devoid of the HIV antibody, so the color is appear. The appearance of the color in the competitive ELISA denote the serum of the patient is negative in HIV antibodies. These are the major difference between these three type of the ELISA. Uses of ELISA. ELISA is used as a diagnostic tool in medicine, plant pathology, biotechnology, as well as quality control check in various industries. It is used in the detection of HIV antibody Mycobacterium antibodies in tuberculosis, rotavirus in fishes, hepatitis B marker in serum, enterotoxin of E. coli in fishes, virus, bacteria, fungi, MLO, mycoplasma-like organism, mycotoxins, aflatoxin and many other biological agent can be detected by ELISA. Thank you.